DJ LeMay, who has a resume. I mean, he's a three-time Gold Glove winner. He got one yesterday. He's a batting titleist. Is he better than you thought he was going to be now that you see him every day?
No, because I had pretty high expectations, honestly. You know, I've watched him enough over the years to know this guy is, you know, to throw out the cliche, he's a professional hitter. Actually, aren't they all? But, I mean, he's really, really good with a bat in his hand, as we've seen it manifest itself. We knew he was capable, or at least we felt strongly that he was capable of the versatility piece where, you know, he's obviously playing a lot of second regularly right now, but feel good about moving him over to third and first, and felt like he could really thrive in that role, and he has. He's been everything I think imagine when we signed him, and he's been a great addition with his personality, albeit very low key but very intense. He's been a great addition to our clubhouse.
Was there ever any concern, Aaron? We're talking with Aaron Boone, the Yankee manager, that Luke Voit after the 2 months last year was fluke Voit and he would not be this good?
Not from us. You know, we were pretty steadfast in internally believing this is who he was. It was a big reason why we went out and obviously acquired him. He delivered the goods in a big way down the stretch for us last year. You know, and right away into spring training looked very much the same guy, and has taken it into the season, and has been one of our most consistent performers, and really it's been the same thing. Strike zone discipline with really good power to all fields, and that's been the result.
On any level, and I know, Aaron, that the answer is, of course, you'd much rather have your full team healthy, but is there any element that's fun about it, going into having a period where you really don't know what to expect and overachieving like this?
I think you just said it very well. Look, this has been fun. It's been fun to see different guys that you weren't necessarily counting on this early in the season genuinely impacting your club in a big way and allowing us to win games. But, you know, that said, you can't wait to get everyone back in the mix, because we really feel like, even though we're playing well now, we do feel like in a lot of ways when we're at full strength, I believe we have a really special club potentially.
Now, do you think that when everybody goes down injured, Aaron, does it release pressure from the whole organization? Now, this organization always expects to win, but if you did not win at this rate, there's certainly an explanation, if you want to use the word excuse. I mean, you're playing people that were in the minor leagues, and they're in the minor leagues for the reason that they're not as good as the guys that started. So is there less pressure when you run this type of lineup out, and can you play more loosey-goosey?
No. There's... because, you know, you're so, you know, from a competitive standpoint, you're so uber focused every day on, and I always say the greatest part about playing this game or being in my job now is the bottom line at the end of the day, we want to shake hands. And that's, there's no better feeling than that. When you get a win in the big leagues and you accomplish something, you play well, whatever it is, and you get to that 5-10 minutes of congratulating each other, well done, job well done, because you know all the work that goes into it. That's kind of the expectation you show up to work with every day, and there's nothing better than that. And the bottom line is, we think we have a potentially special club this year, and so these games become really important, and it's important that we play well no matter what our situation is. So that is the sole focus.